The word is ni'mah. Probably a word you know. Ni'mah. What does ni'mah mean, commonly translated? Blessing. The plural of ni'mah is an'um. 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 Okay, so ni'mah is singular. An'um is plural. And then the powerful plural is ni'am. Ni'am. Okay, so you have ni'mah, and you have an'um, and you have ni'am. It's pretty cool in the Quran, only one time Allah used an'um. And only one time Allah used ni'am. That's it. One time the weak plural, one time the super plural. And what's even cooler is when you're reading the English translation, will they make a distinction between the weak and the powerful plural, or will they just say blessings? It'll just say blessings, you won't even know there's a difference. Okay. Allah Azza wa Jal talks about Ibrahim alayhi salam. Very powerful. Describing Ibrahim alayhi salam, Allah says, Shakiran li an'umihi. Did you hear the plural? Shakiran li an'umihi. An'um is the weak plural, and it was used for Ibrahim alayhi salam. It is as though Allah is saying he was grateful to the few favors of Allah. But that sounds wrong. That sounds strange. When we think of Ibrahim alayhi salam, we think of him as thanking Allah for what? Many favors. But the ayah says he was grateful to Allah for few favors. If Allah wanted to say many, many, many favors, he would have said shakiran li ni'amihi. But the other context, Allah Azza wa Jal says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَأَسْبَغَ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعَمَهُ ظَاهِرَةً وَبَاطِنًا. He unleashed His favors on you. He unleashed His blessings on you. The ones you can see and the ones you cannot see. ظَاهِرَةً وَبَاطِنَةً. Is this a context of few or many? So he used ni'am.